build with hat. I definitely like I like the teleport build, honestly. I need a little bit more play with it. Like I said, I've only played one game on her. But I did like it. I think if you're gonna soul lane, I like this.
Howdy.
$15 a day? Feels bad, man. Maybe if you shared your opinion on patch notes, it could increase these viewers.
Yeah, maybe if I did that.
Donations, for instance, have you discussed the changes to Hinterland Blast?
No, I haven't.
You should consider playing Rager as you were.
Howdy.
Me Link, why
Jesus.
You know where you're bling
Billy 3205. Huge donation there. Thank you very much for the donation. Mingling, why you know where you're bling bling. You know, if I did go over the patch notes and everything else, that would probably increase my viewership and the amount that people want to donate and everything else too. So you guys are probably right.
Can you show use the new Sylvanas strat where you haunting wave into the enemy team?
Yeah. Hold on, I gotta kill everything here. Hold on. If I hit a big damage there, can we kill him? Jesus. Give me one kill, boys. Give me one kill. No! He's gonna live! I could have killed them all! I messed up so hard! Arrgh! That was a quadra kill and I fucked that up so bad. I'm so bad at this new hero. Arrgh, I'm tilted. I'm done. Alright, I gotta go. It was a nice stream. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Shit, dude. Thank you very much, everybody, for the donations. I didn't mean that to be a total sob story, but I do very much appreciate each and every one of your guys' donations. They definitely support. I didn't even pick a talent. That's how tilted I was. I very much support. The support is absolutely needed, and I do really do appreciate it. I had a quadra kill there though, and I failed so hard. All right. So I think Q overall is like just like a decent like poking concept and everything else. That hat is gonna eat my soul alive, honestly. Especially with Zeratul. Here comes the hook. I'm dead, so I might as well try and get a kill, but I still got wrecked. Ah! That sucks. That was my bad. Oh, we're extended. I don't know what we're doing with laning phase here. We also have an Avatar on Dragonshire. Shit I didn't think about. You should give a warning when you rage like that. I just opened your... I apologize. I probably should. I need to work on getting like a stabilizer to where my voice can never go above a certain tone. Like, even if I scream. That's my bad, honestly, man. Alright, we're good. We got that big dick damage, you know what I'm saying, Shotty? We got that big dick damage. Yeah, girl, what up? Hit him with that fadeaway. I missed it with that fadeaway, because I suck at this game, and I'm terrible at this hero, and I just hate my life, and I'm... Ugh. Alright, so what I did last time is I actually went... Dead? I'm dead? Oh, I'm not dead? That talent just saved my life. Nice. Is that Vala coming to kill me? Yeah, Heron knows, dude. He wants that. He wants a piece of this juicy little booty. Oh shit, everybody wants a piece of this juicy little booty. Hey, girl. But last time I played there, my first time, I actually took takedowns, restore health. So you can go in very deep with your E constantly. It's something I want to try. I do have a noise gate. I just don't have it set up to where it maximizes how loud I can talk. I'm gonna not get hooked here, hopefully. So here I got more kills, so I get more heals. And then I blink in, get more damage, and I just proceed to kill everything. And
Howdy.
I can
Let's
have this-
It's fun to get you the last credits you need to graduate emo.
I appreciate the donation, thank you very much. So, if you notice, I can have this aggressive- Oh, that was a really bad- I can have this kind of aggressive positioning because I've taken the healing on my ult. Which allows me to just reset my like my health bar essentially too, so it's really valuable. I like dominance. Like I said, this is only my second game on her, but it's really useful, especially if you go shield build because she is very squishy and resetting your cooldowns definitely helps you out there. So, all right, and with that bomb, I just. Took a shit ton of damage because turrets hurt so bad. Okay, so here I go. Here's Calamity. Here's where shit starts getting fun. This is when I start liking this hero. Rip, missed it. I'm not gonna yee in there. Winter waited out. We got the cap. Hopefully he delayed on mid long enough. Good job. I like Dominance Dreadnought. You guys quote me at the worst shit, dude. Why do you guys gotta hate me like that? Alright, so, like this. Oh, I missed my blink! I'm dead. I'm bad. Just report. I gotta hit my blink, that's for sure. He's gonna hook. Zeratul's down here. Yeah, there's Zeratul. If I get in on this at all, thank you. Oh, I missed the kill. RIP. So close. I need to get a little bit more XP and a little bit better at this build, and I think it could be really strong. With Illusionist, it also becomes a lot more influential because you gain the increased range. So we'll test that out a little bit here. I've got butts to bite, Dreadnought. You guys are terrible, dude. Yeah, the blink is a really hard skill to use at first, but I do assure you, with a little bit of practice, I'm going to start figuring this shit out. Memorizing the range on it's the most crucial thing. Is Li-Ming good? Li-Ming? Honestly, I don't know yet. I'm really torn. I haven't really got to play her that much. Nice. Didn't get that kill at all. I did dodge a skill shot, though, with that blink, so that's pretty neat. But... give me the glow, give me the glow, give me the glow, thank you. Alright, so I do need to, get a little bit more kill potential on my own as well here. Now what I'm going to do that with is, with our ultimates, I should be able to have a little bit more kill potential. Dude, just back off. He's going to dash into me an arrow. Yeah, there is no hope. I might have been able to line of sight a different way. I should have just blinked the initial hook, honestly. I didn't see the vola there either. That was just bad. But as the longer it goes, the more survivability Li-Ming gets with this type of build. Like I said, I don't know if this is the best. This is just, when I first saw her, I thought this was like the coolest build. At 13 and 16 is where I feel like she hits really big spikes. Zeratul. No! Die, you son of a bitch. Kill him! I needed the reset! Ah! I needed the reset. Somebody help me. How did he not die? I'm so bad, dude. Oh, second game on this hero, and I have no idea what I'm doing. I was so close, dude. Jesus. I'm so bad at her. The almost plays right there, dude. Blink in, kill, blink out was the plan. It's called a Dreadicide. I think Dreadicide fits that a lot more, and I'm really good at Dreadiciding. He's stuck in that chokehold, so that's a really good ult spot for me there. Keep in mind, my ult's a really short cooldown, so I should probably burn it a little bit. Or just kind of freely. Stick with my team here. Zeratul looks like he's trying to get on that ass, I think, here. Malphite's a little bit out of position for sure. Good job there. Twilight the Dream is out. Mosh Pit's about to happen too. I've got big ult damage, though. Alright, so because I get the kill, I get the refresh on health, and then it keeps me alive there in all those situations where they try and ult in me. So that was pretty nice. I really like that level 4. Why did Mal take the silence? Because it's god tier, dude. Alright, here we got Illusionist. I'm gonna suicide here. If I had more mana, actually, I would. I'm about to make a play, hold on. Or misplay, for that matter. Really? Am I gonna die? Nice. I'm so dead. so dead. I don't know why I thought that was a good idea to stay over there. I thought Nova was gonna, or Vala was gonna come for a second. I was gonna do something. Instead, I decided to suicide. I got confused because they were talking about somebody trolling, but it's like a viewer game, so like, is there such thing as trolling? I'm just a little confused. All because he took Twilight Dreams, so I'm trying to figure that out. That was my bad. Chu went 1v4 with her earlier. I guarantee, yeah, no, you very much can get away with huge plays like that if you get opening damage on them. Did Chu run E-build at all? I want to know what kind of build he decided to go. I haven't seen anybody else play her, and this is only my second time actually even playing her, and I wanted to try it one more time. I feel a little crippled on it for the most part. I really do like Diamond Skinned a lot. I also really like a Dominance, but everything else I'm really confused. That was really big damage. Okay, can I survive this? Answer is no. I lied. That was really bad on my part. Die, you son of a bitch! I'm dead now. No! 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 If I hit 16, I would have killed them all. That was my bad. That was my B. So close, but yet so far. Alright, so what I want to do with this next game is I am actually going to look to...
My flaccid dick is out in front of four girls in the red light district of Amsterdam, and I have no idea how I got into this situation.
Welcome to the Dreadnought Club, Beta Wolf LP. Thank you for resubscribing for the second month in a row. That noise gets me every time I hear it. I just cry a little bit on the inside with excitement. I apologize for that. What I want to see, I'm going to hypothesize a different build and play it out next game. Everything was so close to dying, but it just didn't happen. And I just want to kill people, and I just suicide. Are they going to get this? What do I want to do here? Finally, Diamond Skin. Alright, I feel like I gained a lot of strength here in this build. He's going to Twilight the Dream. Sick one. Damn, dude. Everybody's tilting because Twilight the Dream's coming out, I guess. Granted, that was a suicide. I just want to get a Diamond Skin team fight now, please. Was Dread invited to Reynad's birthday party? I wish. Can we go? Can we go? He's going in. He's going in. He's not going to get in team, though. I really want to go. Team? Alright, let's see if I can go with this 1v1. Is Zeratul top? Is Zeratul the top? Oh, now they fight. Oh shit, run. Run! There's Zeratul. RIP, I'm not there to win this fight or lose it for us. Alright, I'm gonna go up there and see how this works out though. I'm about to make mistakes. It's not even moving with my mouse. What just happened? So sad. Vala's gonna sit in this shrub, and what I'm gonna do is actually try and. I'm gonna try and bait. Maybe. Oh, I missed her. Jesus, report. I do have Diamond Skin. Should be fine here. Mainly because I do have Diamond Skin. Oh shit, I suicided for it, I'm dead! Remember how Ming Li can just like bait everybody and then heal herself the full and then get shit up? Like all you gotta do is just get chunked and then you get to blink everywhere. It's cancer. I really like Illusionist. That was the first time I've actually gotten to see it reproc, so I get double E's back to back, and that was really nice. So if you get hit with an ultimate, it's like really forgiving. I kind of liked it, honestly. Alright, let's see. Gonna push on mid? No. Gonna push on bot. I didn't even get to really be the playmaker in that last fight, sadly. But how Illusionist works, for those who don't know, the one that I took, is it essentially increases my E range, but then if I take a shit ton of damage, I get to use it again, and it can't happen more than every 4 seconds. This is crazy. And that was like with Dominance, how I just went from no health to full health. I tank so much damage for your team. I did, especially when I have like diamond skin. This build is really weird. Like I said, I don't know if this one's the most viable, but it's just crazy. Half mana seems like an issue. That is true. I question whether or not Aetherwalker is actually needed. What I want to do here is I'm just going to blink really aggressively and hopefully get a kill. Oh, and nobody confirmed that kill. See, if I confirmed that, I would have blinked and healed and gotten diamond skin up again and been able to just blink everywhere. It did suck getting gorged that deep, but still. I want to see how it works. I want to get more into the team fight, sadly. You tanker baited that team fight. yeah, a little bit. Gotta drink a little bit more of that coffee.
My flaccid dick is out in the red light district of Amsterdam. I have no idea how I got into this situation.
Trickslayer, welcome to the Dreadnought Club, man. Thank you for resubscribing for the second month in a row. What's the build? This build is weird. Like I said, I don't know if it's good, but it is fun. I need to test a lot more out on her. What it is, I don't know if this is the right answer. I think I would not take this. I think I would take Astral Presence, or I would take Power Hungry, one of the two. Dominance, Calamity. I really like Calamity. I really like Dominance. Disintegrate, Illusionist, Diamond Skin. Was it, what is that sub voice from? It's actually from Reynad's stream. I did a Reynad cosplay recently. You can find the clips on YouTube here. I'm gonna shit on this team fight. See if she takes a little bit too much poke, I might be able to make a play. Somebody kill the sidewall? Team? So this is why this build is really cool though, is like watch this even. Like I don't even have to kill him, but like just watch how much, like in their face. I didn't even hit him with my blink, sadly. I'm really tanky though, right? So every 4 seconds I get to just pop my E and get a lot of health. And if we get a single kill, it's 25% of my health. And if we get kill, then I get 25% more, right? So like, it's a unique situation here. I don't want to end yet. I want to take one more team fight if we can. There's a Zeratul on me. So there it is. I heal up and then I kill shit, which is totally awesome. His burst allowed me to double E. So here we go. We're going to try it one more time here. I'm gonna get silenced. He didn't even silence, okay. Well, you know. He's gonna silence now? There we go, we get another blink. But ultimately, you just get to blink on shit everywhere and do a lot of damage in the process, and it's quite a bit of fun. Especially if you take a shit ton of bursts at first, like I said, it'll give you the reset, which will give you 2 diamond skins, which is 50% of your maximum health. We aren't gonna win the game yet? Okay. We're looking for a kill. I don't know where he went. I wasn't paying enough attention. Leorg did end up dying. It is a lot of fun though. The wave of force at 20 is broken. Increases the knockback by 150%. Increases the cast range. That's interesting. All right, we're gonna look to play it. I want to play a couple more games with different builds. Does anybody have any other specific builds that you think is really good on her? This, like I said, this is only the first build I thought of when I read her kit. I have legitimately not seen anybody play it or like the idea of what to build on her at all. I don't know if I can solve this.
Is out in front of four girls in the red light district.
See how I can tank so much damage on the core? It's crazy. Go, Gator Tail. Let's kill everything, dude. Ugh. GatorTail89, welcome to Dreadnought Club, man. Thank you for subscribing for the second month in a row. We're gonna do a little bit of a different build here this next game.